Hi, I'm Chris Kepler, and welcome to Does This Happen to You? I'm an actor, voice actor, audiobook narrator, and writer. I love telling and sharing stories about the strange experiences my friends and I have while doing mundane things like grocery shopping. That's why this podcast features funny stories from fantastic writers about our daily anomalies, a micro audiobook about life and befuddlement just for you. Our story this week is from B.B. Nicholson, who you'll find on Medium.com. And here is Parenting Tips for the Clueless, Don't Throw Your Child Over a Fence, and Other Rules You Might Not Know. The media is so full of stories about politics, elections, and coronavirus that I decided to cast around for news that didn't concern these hot-button topics. And this is what I found. An elementary school in France has banned late-arriving parents from hurling their kids over its closed gate when dropping them off. You heard me right. Parents are hurling their kids over a fence. And it just isn't a little fence. According to the principal, it's a six-footer. Maybe you're different, but I couldn't lift a child gently and gracefully over a six-foot fence. I would have to sling the child with all the force I could muster, like flinging a cat by its tail, and even with that effort, the child would likely land smack into it. A dangerous business. The principal of the school agreed. She said it was only a matter of time before a child got hurt. Educators put up posters at the school's entrance depicting an adult throwing a kid over a fence with the words, "Attention, danger." The prospect of hurling children over fences did two things for me. It showed me real life beats satire, and it aroused my curiosity about other unusual laws and regulations related to parents and kids. So, instead of reading about election fraud and a steep rise in COVID-19 cases, I searched the internet for bizarre rules related to parenting. I'm posting a few of them here in case you, too, are ready for a news break. In Alaska, no child is allowed to build a snowman taller than himself or herself on school property. Why? Because teachers might not be able to tell a real child from a snowman. I think I could tell a child from a snowman, but maybe not. But when do children have time during school to build snowmen that big anyway? But I guess it's a moot point with virtual schooling unless somebody decides to play hooky by putting a snowman in front of their computer. In New Zealand, Kim Kardashian and Kanye West would need to choose a different name for their child because they wouldn't be allowed to name it Saint. This is a jolt to our Wild West, anything-goes American mentality. Whoever heard of telling us what we can name our kids? But in New Zealand, you can't give your children names that resemble official titles. That goes for names like Prince, King, and Royal, too. Parents who tried it were disappointed, as those have been some of the most commonly rejected names. Moving on to Poland, be careful about sending your kid to school in a Winnie the Pooh shirt. One village in Poland issued a ban on Winnie the Pooh because the character was found to be too risque for impressionable children. You're wondering why? Haven't you noticed the bear doesn't have on any pants? He's just wearing a t-shirt, and therein lies the problem. In Mexico, the pandemic has led to new public policies designed to protect the health of children. The latest of these is an anti-junk food law in the southern state of Oaxaca. In a vote of 31-1, legislators agreed to ban the sale of